drop the candy, and back away from the ball.
Hey, it was just a couple of Starbursts. You know, what happened to all the Nestle's Crunch?
I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Well, I may have had one. What was it, the bag? I don't know. I was lost in a sugar haze.
Oh, man, Dad, what are we going to do now? We hardly have any candy left.
Miranda, don't panic, my brother. Don't panic. See, you're too focused on the treat. I'll show you a little trickerini here.
Trick-or-treat.
Hi, sweetie. Oh, what a beautiful costume.
Thank you.
I'll give you $10 for the bucket of candy.
15.
12.
Candy is $15.
All right, done. Happy Halloween.
Wow.
Huh?
Wow, nice job, Dad.
Yeah, see, now we have candy for the kids.
Hi.
Check it out.
Who are you supposed to be?
I'm a pip. Did I tell you that Alex invited Maya Angelou to our party tonight? Yeah, she's in town doing a book tour. I have always wanted to meet her.
She's a lovely woman. Even nicer in person.
Wait a minute. You met Maya?
Met her? Tell her Big Jimmy said hello.
Yo, 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 what's up?
Has that replaced Trick or Treat? Because I didn't get the Def Jam Halloween handbook.
Is Maddie here, Mr. Stevenson?
Oh, you guys must be from the hockey team. Yeah, come on in, come on in. Hey, Maddie, your friends are here.
Wait, I get it. You're Jimmy Walker from the show Good Times, right?
Hey, guys. Heart attack.
Hey, Daddy, did I tell you that Maddie is the first 12-year-old to make the 14-year-old team?
Oh, good. Now he can get his two front teeth knocked out early.
I hope you guys realize what kind of a player you're getting. Yes, he led his Pee Wee League in scoring 2 years in a row.
Dad, they don't care.
Well, that's because they're suffering from Pee Wee envy.
I'll be on my
10,
Grandpa.
Now, wait a minute, wait. No costume?
Oh. We're going as a hockey fight.
Oh. Of course.
Come on, Dad. What are we supposed to go as? Something lame like a ghost or a clown?
Ahoy, matey.
Or a pirate?
All right, Captain Nobeard, let's go. See you, Daddy.
Look at my boys. A pip and a pirate. I am swelling with pride.
You know, I have a very successful law practice. Here's my card. Petey.
Nicole. Wow, a genie.
Yeah. You know, I'm already regretting this costume, though. One of your sales reps came up and asked if he could rub my bottle. Cannot tell you what his first two wishes were, but his third is to get his wind back.
Listen, have you seen Maya Angelou? Everyone says she's here.
Oh, yeah, yeah, and she loved my taquitos.
Really? Am I the only one that hasn't met her?
Oh, Maya, you're something else. I'll be right back with the refund.
Guys, what do you think? The Godfather!
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna make you an offer that you just can't refuse.
This is my favorite scene. This is the one where he's in the garden with his grandson.
Oh, yeah, yeah, and he has a heart attack.
Yeah, this is fabulous.
I was really choking.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
I did.
Another flask of grog, serving wench.
How much grog have you had, Angela?
Xena isn't held by mortal bounds. You shall be my love slave. Take off your shoes and walk on my back.
I think we'd better call Xena a designated chariot. All right, look out. A pip's on the move.
Sorry. I was just trying to catch up to Maya.
That was really Maya Angelou?
Now I feel really bad. I arm wrestled her out of the last taquito.
Oh, a pregnant Madonna. Yes, very clever. Yeah, I guess you can't do like a virgin on tour anymore.
Pip, right?
Second from the left. Woo-hoo! Are you a friend of Alex's? Because I know if I'd met you, I would have remembered.
No, I came with the Incredible Hulk.
Why do the big green guys always get the beautiful women?
He's my brother.
Ben Stevenson.
Kira Lewis.
Nice to meet you.
This is a wonderful party.
It is now. Carl, did I tell you Kira is an architect?
Yeah, you told me that as we were leaving the party.
Did I tell you Kira has a great sense of humor?
Yeah, you told me that as we were getting in the car.
Did I tell you that she loves jazz music?
Yeah, you told me that when I turned up the radio real loud and stuck my head out the window.
Oh, man, sorry you lost Petey.
Hey, Ben, Petey wasn't just a rental bird. He was my first mate.
Stevenson hip checks Hartek. And Hartek slams Stevenson into the board. Good one.
Easy, guys. Easy. You're not at the rink now.
Dad, don't sweat it. We've been body checking each other into walls and stuff all night. Did you know you can set off a car alarm with your head?
Those older boys are going to whip his little 12-year-old butt.
He can handle himself. He's got skill, he's got technique, and he can skate really, really fast. And you can't hit what you can't catch, right?
But when they do catch you, you know what I'm saying, huh?
Look, I know it's not going to be easy for him, but the kid wants this.
So did you. You got all worked up about football your freshman year. Your mother and I prayed every time you put on that uniform. I guess God heard us. Because you dropped a pass in the end zone and got benched for the rest of the season.
No, that was pass interference.
Yeah, those bricks you had for hands interfered with you catching the ball.
Alex, have you ever noticed that there are days when the sky seems just a little bluer and people on the street seem a little nicer and the elevator seems to arrive just as you get there as if to say, hello, Ben.
Buddy, I sure hope this is about the woman you met last night and not the new fragrant hand soap in the men's room.
That's right. But you do smell lemony fresh.
Thank you, Ben. You're welcome.
No, Alex, I feel so great. I haven't felt this good since I'm 18, man. Kira is unbelievable. Yes, she's smart, she's sexy, she's funny.
She's pregnant.
No, that was a costume, man, and a bad costume at that. The big fake belly. No, a real pregnant woman looks more like that.
Hi, Ben.
So, I'll just leave the three of you alone.
You really didn't know I was pregnant, did you?
No idea.
Oh, I am so embarrassed. I thought you knew.
Well, it was a costume party. I mean, you came as Madonna, I came as a Pip. It doesn't mean I'm opening for Flip Wilson.
Look, I feel like I owe you an explanation. I was married a long time. He never wanted kids, so when the marriage ended, I decided to go to a fertility clinic and...
And wow, you came out a winner. Well, I should have known by the glow. I guess I just assumed you came by that naturally.
Look, I can tell that you're uncomfortable, so if you want to forget lunch, really, it's okay.
No, Kira, no, wait. This is crazy. I admit I'm a little taken aback by this, but I like you. And I hope you still like me. Can we still have lunch?
I'd like that.
Great. So, what are you in the mood for? Italian, Chinese, Greek?
Perfect.
You really are pregnant. Hey, there's my superstar. How was your first practice? Don't leave out a thing.
Great, Dad. Tough, but great. Coach made us skate wind sprints from one end of the ring to the other over and over for 40 minutes.
Woo!
Some of the kids even threw up.
And you didn't?
Well, not until I saw Hartek throw up.
Like this. All right, dinner's almost ready.
All right, serve it up. Let's get our grub on.
Maddie?
Yeah, Dad?
All right, you can collapse now. A little sore from practice, huh?
Yeah, But it's a good sore. No pain, no gain, right, Dad?
Yeah. Listen, Maddie, this is no reflection on your talent, but you sure you're ready for this team?
Of course I'm ready. You say yourself I was a great player.
You are a great player.
Please, Dad, you can't pull me out now. Hartek thinks I can make the first line. I can do this. It was just my first practice. I'll toughen up.
Well, I have to admit, whenever you've wanted something this bad, you've always succeeded.
Thanks, Dad.
All right. Dinner's almost ready. You know, this reminds me of the time when I had to talk your grandfather into letting me play football. Yeah, and no matter what your grandpa says, I could play. Yes, I was a pass-catching fool. Hands like suction cups.
So you're having dinner with Kira tonight. Had lunch with her yesterday. Sounds like she's everything you expected her to be.
And more. Much more.
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
Well, brace yourself, Carl. She really is 8 months pregnant. And I would appreciate it if you didn't make an issue of this.
Daddy, Ben's dating a pregnant woman?
That woman's pregnant, Ben?
Don't look at me. It was a donor.
Who does that kind of work?
No, we're not dating. We're not dating. We're just gonna be friends. We're friending.
Oh, come on. After how you talked about this woman, you think you could do that?
Yes, I do. Yeah, Kieran and I agreed that it's too complicated to get involved right now. She's planned having this baby very carefully, and I wasn't a part of that plan. No, no, we're just two people going out for a couple of extra large pizzas and something for me.
Going out with a pregnant woman. I wouldn't go anywhere with your mother when she was pregnant. Terrible indigestion. God love her, that woman belched like a stevedore.
Hey, Maddie, come on. You don't want me late for practice. Let me see all that new equipment I bought you.
Hey, look, it's the crash test dummy.
I want to take chances with the future of the Chicago Blackhawks. Yes, yes, the first in a long line of Stevenson pro athletes. And to ensure that long line, ta-ta! The very latest in athletic protection, made from pure titanium. Yes, same material they use on the space shuttle.
Because remember, in space, no one can hear you scream.
Thanks, Dad.
Here's a controversial subject. Cloth diapers or disposable?
Oh, no question, disposable. Cloth always made me chafe.
How about this one? At what age do you start them on solid foods?
Well, if you're looking to save money, I would say 10 or 11.
Oh. Here's one. Bottle or breast?
You're asking the wrong guy.
So, how are the souffle and cheesecake?
Wonderful.
Good. Ben, are you sure you don't want anything?
Well, no, I'm sure we'll stop for some ice cream on the way home.
Kira, I must say it's amazing that you're doing this on your own. I have to confess, though, I have considered being a self-starter.
Nicole, I never heard you talk like this.
Well, I know, but what if I never find the right guy, Ben? You know, career isn't everything, and it is kind of hard to imagine myself going through my entire life without children.
Boy, since I've been pregnant, I've been losing my hair in clumps.
On the other hand, I could just open an outdoor cafe.
Wow, it's getting late. I should get you home so you can put your feet up, huh?
Are you kidding? The night is still young. I'm not even bloated yet. Let's do something.
What do you have in mind?
Yeah, all right. Yeah. Well, this next groovy tune is going out to the lucky couple on the dance floor.
Thank you. Thank you. It was nothing. And I mean that. Shouldn't be happening.
You're telling me. I think my water just broke.
How are you doing? You breathing?
I'm okay. I'm fine. How about you?
I'm working on it. Excuse me. She's going into labor.
How far apart are the contractions?
I don't know. I didn't time them. How long is Disco Inferno?
Name of mother?
Betty Stevenson, but I don't know why that's important.
Ben, I think she meant me.
Oh, sorry. Kira, Lewis. Breathe. Don't you think we should take her up now?
Name of father.
I have no idea.
Oh, you're one of those.
No. You think it's me? No. We're just friends. We only kissed once. Okay, twice. Down here. That's it.
Hey, Ben.
Hey, Carl. Carl, what are you doing here?
It's okay. Maddie's fine.
Maddie? What's wrong with Maddie?
He hurt his leg in practice. He's coming out of the x-ray.
Ooh, man. She looks like she's about to explode.
Ben, your son needs you. Just go.
All right. Carl, stay with Kira.
Me? She's having a baby.
Just stay with her until the birthing partner gets here, or you have to cut the umbilical cord.
Oh, God.
You're gonna be great. Stay with Kira.
Okay. How you doing?
Oh, excuse me, doctor. I'm Matthew Stevenson's father. Is he okay?
He's fine, Mr. Stevenson. It's just a slight sprain. A week or two, and he'll be back on the ice.
Great.
Go on in.
All right. Thank you. Hi, baby.
Dad.
You okay?
Hey. Yeah, I'm fine. I took a heart attack. Uh-huh. See, he high-sticked me, so I went after him. First, I thought I missed and slammed into the boards. But no, it was him.
My boy.
Dad, I got some bad news.
What?
The doctor says I'm going to be out for 6 to 8 weeks.
He said 6 to 8 weeks, huh?
At least. He said I'm at this weird age. You know, where I don't heal as fast.
Yeah. I actually read something about that age. Yeah, that's where your muscles are contracting and your bones are expanding, leaving your tendons without a real purpose.
That's right. He mentioned those tendons.
Yeah. You know, you may not have to wait the full 6 to 8 weeks. I mean, if you had some place to work your way back, you know, just so you got your legs under you.
Well, you know, Weissman did call the other day. He said my old team has no offense. Think I should go back there?
It's an idea. I mean, you'd be doing them a favor. Who knows how many of those guys are going through that bone-expanding thing.
Dad, I hope you're not too disappointed.
Why would I be disappointed, baby?
Well, I know how much it meant to you. You know, me making the team.
Maddie, you know, when you were born, I thought about all the things you could be. President of the United States, an astronaut, maybe even an NHL hockey player. But as you get older, I realize I love you not so much for what you could become, but for who you are right now.
Thanks, Dad.
Mm-hmm. All right, come on. I'll get you something in the cafeteria. They're famous for their Jell-O. Hello? Anybody been born around here?
Ben.
It's a boy, Ben. We had a boy.
Congratulations. You were out on the fire escape getting air, weren't you?
Oh, you bet. But we had a boy.
Robin and Dana, this is Ben.
Hi. How are you doing?
Why don't you guys go get something to eat?
Hey, now that we shared God's greatest gift, y'all want to go clubbing or something?
Isn't he amazing?
He's amazing. He's beautiful. What's his name?
Anthony.
Anthony. This is for you. The only place open was a gas station across the street, and I hate coming empty-handed. It's a car deodorizer.
New car smell. My favorite. So how's Maddie?
Oh, he's fine. He's downstairs in the cafeteria, drowning his pain in a double hot fudge sundae with a side of tapioca pudding.
Oh, I never knew that I could fall in love this fast.
It's wonderful, isn't it?
This is so overwhelming, Ben. You, the baby.
Well, of course it is. I remember when Maddie was born, we focused all our energy on him. And that's what you have to do.
This is so like me. My timing is never good.
You think your timing is bad now? Wait till he starts waking you up at 2 a.m. Look, Kira, it's hard enough for two parents to raise a child, so I want you to know if you ever need me, I'm here for you. And I also know a 12-year-old who could use the $5 an hour babysitter.
$5 an hour?
Ooh, do you have a lot to learn? All right, gotta get back to Maddie.
Thanks, Ben.
I'll see you, Kira.
Bye. Are you talking already? What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say to your mommy? Is he a mommy?
So, Dad, how's everybody doing?
Well, Kira and the baby are fine. Your Uncle Carl's in recovery. Well, let's get out of this place. It smells like a hospital in here. Are you all right? Are you okay on those?
Yeah.
Here, come on.
You're not gonna pick me up, are you?
You are not so grown up that I can't carry you. Let's go. See?
Dad, I can't believe you're doing this. What if somebody sees me?
Maybe they'll help.
That Gregory Hines is a real, modern, mature, sensitive 90s kind of guy. So maybe I can get my own show.
Yeah, sure. On the Lumber Channel.
You're just angry because you've got termites again.
Well, what makes you think you can get your own show?
I do movie impressions. Watch this, The Exorcist.
Oh, anybody can do that. Let's see what's up next on Step by Step.